Good. Oh, are we on the air?
You can't say things like that. You were already yelled at. We were going live.
They can't yell at me.
They can't yell at me either.
Not anymore.
I'm Kathy Kelly, joined by the man behind NXT, one of my favorite people, obviously making everyone laugh. Takeover Portland here
tonight. Kathy has always been one of the most professional people here. There is potential that before the end of this, she goes off the reservation.
Oh, my gosh, completely.
Yeah.
But this show, people are tweeting. You heard the crowd out there. This is one of the best, if not the best takeover I think NXT has ever put on.
Well, I hope that's what they thought. You know, sometimes when you're putting these together, you get too close to them. This was a big one for us coming here to Portland. I love this market. Portland is always loud and just a crazy bunch.
Yeah.
And it was great to come back, to come here tonight, and we had a hell of a house. But, you know, when you're putting something like this together, this is one of the first sort of big epic takeovers we've done, sort of uncoupled from the Raw and SmackDown pay-per-views, from the bigger, you know, kind of weekend extravaganzas. So to be here in Portland, standing on our own 2 feet, with no support, have a full house here in Portland, have them going crazy, and a little bit of a different card also, you know, a little bit more matches than usual, a little bit of a bigger card. But, you know, when you really look at it, there's so much more we could have put on this card.
But that
you'll see
to
the next few weeks.
The caliber of the talent that is in NXT currently.
Yeah, absolutely. And so I think that though doing that, you know, you try to structure these things and build out the whole show. And I think from top to bottom, this was one to be proud of. So I'm happy for the talent and everybody that put their heart and soul into this. But this was a big night.
Yeah, every superstar clearly fighting for their spot. We have to talk about the kickoff of the show. One of my favorite things. Poppy.
Yes.
She was back. I feel like she's almost synonymous with NXT TakeOver at this point and has become this mainstay. Incredible performance, though.
Yeah, you know, Poppy's one of those things that I feel like when I first kind of had Poppy put in front of me as an artist and all that stuff, I wasn't that familiar with it and immediately was like, oh, my God, this is great. And she fits right into our brand. Mm-hmm. And then when she came here, though, man, she just fits right in, you know, and it's one of those crazy moments where she'll come out with something new and, man, it just fits to do something with us. And she wants to be a part of it. She just gets it. She just kind of like sort of fits right into our world. And she puts on amazing performances. So like what you see here tonight, coming out, doing 2 songs, opening the show, it just kind of sets the vibe and the tone. I always hope that and strive for those things to add to the ambiance of the evening, not be what the evening is or take away from it or be this break in the middle of it, but add to it and build to the epic moment of the show starting. And I felt like tonight, Poppy did that. You know, we came in here, she just had this place rocking, and then you cut right out of that into Keith Lee music, and it just goes limitless from there.
Yeah, I mean, 2 superstars who also had the place rocking, Keith Lee and Dominik Dijakovic, in that NXT North American Championship match.
Yes.
We knew it was going to be good, but you tweeted it afterwards that we all won.
Yeah, insane performance by both guys. You know, just and I think Mark Henry kind of said it in that promotional piece.
Yeah.
You have guys that shouldn't be able to do what they do. You know, Dijakovic is, you know, he's a big dude. You don't realize it until you're standing with him, because I think sometimes he's in the ring with people like Keith or, you know, even like a Damian Priest or something, where there's guys that are his size. But when you're around him, I think he's like 6'7". You know, he's creeping up towards the 300-pound mark. But when you see him, you know, springboard diving all the way, you know, I don't know how far away that is.
It doesn't seem realistic.
Yeah, into a chair. It's just like he shouldn't be able to do that. When you see Keith Lee and him on the top rope and, you know, Spanish fly, you see Keith Lee hitting the moves that he hits, just doing the things that they do. It's just, it's insane the amount of athleticism and how really good they are. And that's a testament to both of them. And it's not just movement for the sake of movement or spots. It's just really good And my hat's off to both of them because they put on an epic performance that just had Portland on fire.
Yeah. Well, I mean, talking about Keith Lee specifically, we saw him at Survivor Series. We saw him at Royal Rumble. We see him every single week on NXT, and it seems like we're firsthand getting a front row seat to the rise of Keith Lee.
Absolutely. But then again, you look at Dijakovic. Dijakovic had a star-making night tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you saw that by the end. This is one of those ones where you go, okay, so they had like this rivalry back and forth, and now you get into the rubber match, and Keith Lee wins that rubber match. But I don't know. I want to see them fight again. Steph always brings it up to me after these pay-per-views. One of her favorite chants is fight forever.
Yeah.
And, here they were. They were chanting it during the match, but I think it's hard not to want to see them fight forever because they're so good. They're matched up so good. This is one of those rivalries that you can see, you can get away from it, but anytime they come back, go face to face, you go, man, I want to see that again, and it's just awesome.
I mean, so many lifelong rivalries are created, and they start right in NXT. Another one, Dakota Kai and Tegan Nox. In that street fight tonight, just continuing what we've seen between these two women. But a new face, Raquel Gonzalez.
Yeah, Raquel Gonzalez coming out. And to me, there's a moment on the end of that where these two women are just tearing it up, having this epic battle. They're laying it all on the line. Mm-hmm. They're just going at it in a way that you rarely see. It's on fire. And Raquel Gonzalez comes out there and puts her stamp on this. And it looked to me like Dakota Kai knew nothing about it. And Dakota Kai was in as much shock as the rest of us, not knowing why she was there. This is going to be interesting because, to me, what it looked like at the end was one of those epic, and this is always kind of the measuring stick, I think, for those kind of relationships. But the epic Shawn Michaels Diesel moment with this big giant Raquel Gonzalez standing behind Dakota Kai, and you think to yourself, wow, if Dakota Kai was that good on her own, if she has backup, if she has somebody like that standing behind her,
what can she accomplish?
Yeah, what can she accomplish? So
or what can she not, like the sky is the limit for her.
Yeah, and so to me, this is one of those really cool moments where you get this epic, I feel like I'm getting the last chapter in a great novel of this battle between two former best friends that are now bitter enemies, mm-hmm. and I'm going to get that final payoff, and wait, there's a twist and a whole new chapter to this, and I have no idea where it's going to go next. That's when it's at its best, and I feel like that's where we were tonight.
Yeah. Well, two other mainstays in NXT, Finn Balor and Johnny Gargano. We saw them lay it all out there tonight.
Yeah.
I want to get into this. I also want to talk about what happened with Johnny later in the night because, going from the heart and soul of NXT, being that for years, and then what we saw from him later this evening.
Well, I'll go with the superhero analogy that I believe would resonate with Johnny Gargano. What's that saying? You live long enough to see yourself become the villain, right? Let's talk about that match first. Finn Balor, Johnny Gargano, two guys that you could say in their time within NXT planted the flag in the ground to say, this was my brand.
Mm-hmm.
NXT, I'm going to take to another level. I believe in it. It's my heart and soul, and I am that brand. And then Finn left and went on to do other things and came back. And here's Johnny Gargano saying that it's still his. And that intense rivalry over what they believe is theirs.
Mm-hmm.
What I loved about that match was the differences in just these first three matches of tonight's show. You saw this epic battle of big men. You saw this insane, bitter rivalry street fight between two women just going to unbelievable lengths to beat each other. And then you get into a wrestling match between two just pure technicians in that ring, just really putting on a clinic. And that's what I loved about it. And then when you get to the end, Finn Balor, I think whatever flag that Johnny Gargano felt was his NXT flag, Finn Balor took it from him and drove it through his heart tonight and made the statement that NXT is his brand and he's here to stay. And that's a statement. Those are the kind of things that if you believe in yourself that much about being the brand, those are the kind of things that drive you over the edge and that can push you to doing things that maybe and irrational state of mind you wouldn't do, which would bring us to the end of the night, and Johnny Gargano maybe coming full circle to a moment when Tommaso Ciampa looked like he was about to get his life back, that maybe that isn't what's best for Johnny Gargano. Yeah. But we can talk about that in a minute.
In a bit. NXT has made history this year. Being a live weekly show on the USA Network, the women have also made history in it being the first time an NXT championship will be defended at WrestleMania. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we had an incredible match tonight between Rhea Ripley and Bianca Belair, a rivalry that maybe we'll see down the road again, but that statement made by Charlotte Flair coming out, accepting Rhea's challenge, and seeing this championship defended on the grandest stage of them all.
Yeah, so let's talk about that match first. Rhea Ripley, Bianca Belair. Rhea Ripley, and you know, you can see these moments. You talk about NXT being on the air live 2 hours now in USA. You've seen that opportunity of that second hour creating stars.
Yeah.
You've seen it with Keith Lee. You've seen it with Dijakovic. You've seen it with Dakota Kai and Tegan Knox.
Yep.
You come into this match tonight, and you see it again. You see Rhea Ripley, who's been on a rocket ship ride over the last 4 or 5 months.
At 23 years old.
At 23 years old, of getting to the top, of you know winning the NXT UK Championship, of that not panning out exactly the way she wanted to, coming here, reinventing herself, and just on this rocket ship. You could make arguments over the last few months of who's had the greatest, you know, last half of 2019 and beginning of 20. She'd have to be at the top of that list.
Yeah.
Pinning Charlotte Flair at one point, beating up Sasha Banks, and just all the stuff that she did through Survivor Series and to everything that she's gotten to where she is and becoming NXT champion, taking down Shayna Baszler, which most people thought couldn't be done. Epic rise. And you on the other side of that, you look at Bianca Belair. So just having this conversation with Bianca backstage as I was being introduced to her mom and dad. The first time she really stepped through the ropes with us to train was in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
It's the beginning of 2020 now, 4 years. Name a profession that in 4 years you could go from never having stepped onto that field, that court, that whatever it is, and 4 years later, you're one of the best in the world. If that doesn't speak to how good of an athlete Bianca Belair is, if that doesn't speak to the kind of dedicated, hardworking, just amazing on all levels performer and athlete that she is, then nothing should, right? And to stand in that ring tonight, win, lose, or draw with Rhea Ripley on this stage, what an epic performance. And if you just backtrack just a short period of time, you know, you say 4 years, but if you backtrack 3 years ago, she was already in that main event picture, but hadn't put all the pieces together yet. Tonight, that was a polished performer. Tonight, that was somebody that not only is getting a shot at the main event, is the main event. I thought for both of them. And win, lose, or draw, they both won tonight. And on the end of that, Charlotte Flair coming in and staking her claim in a unique way of winning the Royal Rumble and not calling out or not choosing a Raw champion or a SmackDown champion, but for the first time ever, choosing the NXT Women's Champion to go to WrestleMania. She came here tonight, made a statement to Rhea Ripley. And like you said, at WrestleMania, Rhea Ripley versus Charlotte Flair.
That gives me chills just thinking
about
it.
Yeah, and then, you know, I can backtrack to the day that Charlotte walked through the door of you know, the Performance Center and NXT and got that start. And to see that come full cycle, it's incredible to see. It's awesome to see. I noticed that Charlotte had a little bit of a last-second button on there for Bianca Belair, let's say payback for a statement made at NXT on USA. I don't know that that's quite done yet either.
Oh.
So the beautiful thing about this is while you can look and say WrestleMania is right around the corner, Rhea, Charlotte, I don't think Bianca Belair is quite done with this whole scenario yet. You know, I think that there's more to come, and I think that over time this will play out to be very interesting for people.
Excited to see that.
But again, I'll just make that statement. The women of NXT, strongest women's division anywhere in the world, I say that with all certainty, from the Dakota Kai Tegan Knox match to that Rhea Ripley Bianca Belair match. Holy cow. Like,
when you have that kind of unbridled passion and drive, it has to be.
Yeah, and the people running up behind them, it's intense.
Yeah. Rose City turned into Bros City tonight. The NXT Tag Team Championship match. Of course, the Bros are Reigns beating Undisputed Era. I can't even imagine how wild that celebration is going to be.
No. I had the weirdest thing. My plane smelled terrible on the way to Portland. Yeah, I don't know. There's smoke issues in the back. I don't know what was going on. But anyways, yeah, that's what the pilot said. There was some kind of smoke.
Okay.
But anyways, we got to Portland, and those guys put on an unbelievable performance, which leaves you questioning only one thing. Like, actually, how much fish could Bobby Fish fry if Bobby Fish could fry fish?
Did you get an answer to that?
I did not yet. But I think the world is going to keep asking it until they find out. Even Bobby Fish was asking it. I saw it on the Tron.
Yeah.
Amazing tag match. The Broserweights. You know, it's a funny thing that sometimes I feel like every now and then, like, people talk about tag teams that have been together for years and their chemistry and all that stuff. You know, sometimes you put two guys together and there's this instant chemistry. Pete Dunne and Matt Riddle got together, and there was this instant chemistry where suddenly it was like they had been tagging, you know. And I'm not even just talking about, oh, they do some nifty moves together. I'm talking about, like, the, man, it's almost as if they know what each other's going to do before the other guy does it kind of chemistry, which is very rare. Those are rare moments indeed when teams like that can come along and just go past a tag team like Bobby and Kyle, which was incredible. So, new NXT Tag Team Champions, Dusty Cup Champions, they're having a hell of a year.
Definitely. And then that NXT Championship match, we have to talk about it. Adam Cole, Tommaso Ciampa, everything that ensued. An unfinished rivalry between Johnny Gargano and Ciampa. Of course, Undisputed Era went through it tonight, but Adam Cole still retaining.
It's a funny thing. So, it's the unstoppable force, immovable object. One guy's got to get his life back. One guy says, it's my life, you ain't taking it. You know, and what gives, right? They're going to both fight. I used to say it all the time. When it came to a championship, I would fight as if my life depended on it, because as far as I was concerned, it did. Mm-hmm. They were both fighting like their lives depended on it. Tommaso Ciampa had, you know, a life that he had to give up. He never lost it. It was never taken from him. He just had to give it up. And he had the opportunity to get it back tonight. And one of the guys that's been one of his best friends and his worst enemies, I think, decided that it wasn't his life to get back. And
what does that do for your psyche?
I don't know. You know, those guys have been on this roller coaster ride with each other. And I feel like in some way, you know, Sean and I went through that for years. You know, at any moment in time, there was this professional rivalry on the other side of that. We were as close as could be. I think it's that same way with these two. Yeah. I think they're going to do this for a long period of time.
I'm sure probably, Gargano would also very much appreciate that.
Yeah,
that.
Probably destined to do it forever.
Yeah.
But I think we all win in that situation, because anytime I've ever seen Gargano and Ciampa have a rivalry together, it's been incredible. It's been epic, and it's been something that we want to see. So Adam Cole ends up fighting like his life depends on it and ends up keeping it. Tommaso Ciampa doesn't quite get his life back, but it's funny, his life sort of kind of went right back to where it was before he was ever champion.
Mm-hmm.
So in a way, I don't know, maybe he did get his life back.
Poetic.
Yeah, yeah. Funny how that works out.
Well, top to bottom, incredible show.
Yeah.
Excited to see where NXT goes towards WrestleMania this year.
As am I. You know, the beautiful thing is we're now on that path to WrestleMania to TakeOver. We announced it tonight. TakeOver Tampa, as you saw, is going to be epic. I promise you that. As good as this card was, that will be better. We also announced tonight that on April 26th in Dublin, Ireland, NXT UK will take their next epic leap into TakeOver, and that should be spectacular as well. If there's one thing I know about Dublin crowds, they are loud. So we will very much be looking forward to that. And then, of course, this Wednesday live on USA, you know, a big epic night. Mm-hmm. We've got Leo Rush and Jordan Devlin for the Cruiserweight Championship. And also Roderick Strong and Velveteen Dream in what is very quickly becoming a very personal and heated rivalry. So that should be epic as well.
Yeah.
But in other big news for you tonight, right? Yeah. So, you know, for anybody that doesn't know, this is her last night. And, you know, she's so mad at me. She's so mad at me.
Because I'm just thinking about you being mad about me crying.
I won't be mad, but, you know, so much goes into what we do. So much goes into this product. You know, you talk about these athletes that go out there and they pour their heart and soul into this. But we have a saying here, and it's goes to everybody that works on this because they all pour their heart and soul into it. It's the people that are pulling cables. It's the people that are plugging things in. It's the people that are setting up this arena. It's the people that are making the food. They make all of this happen. People that are making the gear, but it's across everything from the set lights being set up to the cameras to people that do what Kathy does each and every week. You know, they are the heart and soul of what we do, and it's because of the passion and the heart and what they put into this that it is good as it is. The reason that the performers can be as good as they are is people like you. And the one thing about this is when I say we are NXT, it's all of us. The great thing about NXT also is you can't get away from us. So we are NXT. You will always be NXT. This is not goodbye. This is see you down the road. This is a moment in time where you get to grow. It's one of the great things about here. We create them and we ship them out the door to do amazing things in the world. I'm not saying this because you're here. This is one of the smartest, most professional, just, I can't say enough good things about her. And, you know, I'm crushed that you're leaving.
Yeah.
But I'm also proud of you for leaving because you should follow your dreams. You should want to do what you do. The door's always open.
Yeah.
This is your home. We are NXT.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know how special this show was to me before I came here, and I'm just so grateful to have been a part of it the last 4 years.
Yeah.
So thank you.
So now that you've got that out of the way, there are other people that want to say...
Kathy.
Oh, no.
Kathy. Oh. Come on.
Really?
They say there's only four members of the Undisputed Era, but given the exception, we could welcome you to be the unofficial, maybe sort of, kind of. The number before six, it's five, the fifth member of the Undisputed Era. So you got your left hand, that's your U.
Okay.
You got your right hand, that's the E. Okay. You want to put the left in front of the right.
Okay.
Yeah, don't mess it up.
Well, actually, maybe put this one down. Put them down a bit.
Yeah, just a little bit lower.
Maybe just put this one here. Yeah, and then
that's
if you move back just a bit,
just a little bit,
and then
just one step.
It's a good
just
shot.
Just one step back.
The idea is really nice about the making her the fifth, but maybe we love her. But maybe it'd be easier if we just gave her a gift.
Yeah, good idea.
Maybe two.
Good idea.
Okay.
Do you think I could get your Twitter handle?
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh. There it is.
Four man gift
for you. There it is for you.
Forever and ever. You don't have to keep
donuts
forever.
You've got zero carbs, zero fat.
Yeah. No
zero protein, zero calories. They're really good. 100%.
They're like
Kyle made them.
They're like eating air.
They're like little donut vitamins.
Oh my god, this looks amazing.
Let's try them.
You want to? What about that one? That looks like your favorite.
It's bacon.
It has bacon on it.
I'll save it for later.
Well, that's why I grabbed the wrapper.
Exactly. He just hand sanitized.
So he didn't wash.
But I know, I know, we've picked on you a fair amount. But he just know
a fair amount. Yeah,
it was out of love.
Yeah, we love you, Cassie. Yeah. We really do.
You brought a lot to the Undisputed Era and everything that we are, and getting to work with you is true pleasure. So
we're gonna miss you more than you know. More than you know.
A big and giant group hug.
Yeah, big. Look at that. Do we want to complete
I'm actually the photo.
Complete the circle.
You're the best. You're the best. It's not going to be the same.
Don't get donuts on me.
Don't get your donuts on me. Thank you.
You never leave home. You never really leave home.
Thank you.
We are NXT.
Thank you, guys.
You know the line that we always say at the end? And that's...
Undisputed.
Yeah.
She does, baby.
She got it.
Thanks, Kathy.
Thank you.